Very good morning to one and all present here. Today we are going to see about another interesting domain, material handling and its importance in workplace. Let us have a basic understanding. What do you mean by material handling? It is a device or an equipment which helps to transfer the bulk amount of raw material from source to destination. By doing so, we can able to improve the complexness in manual lifting. So we cannot use human manpower for much of the task in manual handling. So to improve the speed and the process of operation to be much more simplified, we require a sophisticated material handling system. Next, what are the basic importance of material handling? It tries to improve the production control and operation system in a systematic and streamlined way. So thereby, we can able to minimize the total production cost by efficient usage of material handling within the shop floor environment. And also, the effective usage of material handling tries to improve the overall performance of the plant layout that indirectly supports the design, plant layout design, and its internal features or facilities, which strongly influence the operable condition of material handling. Let us go to the basics of, that is, objectives of material handling system. So the primary objective is to reduce the manufacturing lead time by minimizing the unit handling cost per batch of material. The next, providing a systematic flow of raw material without any stagnation point in a continuous phenomenon, and providing a better working environment by improving the quality by avoiding avoiding damages to the products and increasing the storage capacity of the raw material as a overall. Following are some of the factors which strongly affects the selection of material handling system, and these are the three factors we are going to see in brief one after the other. The first one is production problem. So depending on the use of the production system, that could be a batch production or a mass production or job production, based on the type of a production system, we have to select the so-called material handling device in order to accommodate within the working environment. And next thing, depending on the layout planning and design, we can able to suit the necessary choice of the material handling system. And next, category of material that can be considered as less weight, heavy weighted material, medium weight material, depending on the density and the physical structure. So depending on the nature and geometry of the raw material, we have to categorize the necessary availability of the material handling vehicle to be used. And next comes the equipment factors. What are the major equipment factors to be considered for successful design and selection of the material handling system? First one is flexibility and adaptability. So these are the most essential thing for any material handling vehicle. And next one, controlled speed. So the so-called material handling system should be operated within the minimum operable speed inside the shop floor. That is at the rate of 10 to 20 kilometer speed range. Then space requirements. So the provided space requirement must be highly compatible, and there should not be any obstacle kept on the path. The path must be free from obstacles so that the material handling systems can able to freely move on from the source to the destination point. And these are the following the factors which supports the material handling design and its aesthetic aspects. Let us take environmental maintenance, overall the power utility, loading capacity. And efficient supervision. These are some of the factors which influence the equipment selection. So the most important factors are adaptability, flexibility, maintenance cost, suitable to the environment, then efficient supervision of the material handling systems every day in and day out, and movement of material handling system in a spontaneous manner within the space conditions, safely within the space limit. These are the most important thing to be considered for the selection of the material handling. And at last, the load and power capacity and maintenance. Next, coming to the human ergonomics factors, the skill set of the human worker, that is the capability of a human worker, and safety of the human personnel depending on the ergonomics concepts. So in the next slide, which gives you the information about the body ergonomics of a human worker when he is allowed to do a manual work without the usage of the material handling system or any lifting equipment. So if you do these kind of works without any lifting mechanism, at the end of the day, you will experience a muscular dislocation problem. So to avoid the fatigue related to muscular dislocation, it is advisable to use the industry lifting mechanism, that is a so-called material handling vehicle, in a much compatible way. So what are the associated hazards present in a material handling system? What are the common mistakes we people will commit when we are operating a material handling system inside the plant layout? If the plant layout is very poor, unhygienic in nature, there is no space, a broad path provided. If there is no broad path provided inside the shop floor, so it is not for us to take a turn very easily. It may go and hit on the sharp edge when you are turning either left or right. Then the material will begin to fall away from the vehicle. That will lead to scratch and severe damage. Then height restrictions are there. Then overturning, sudden overturning. Then collision due to overturning and impacting the people on equipment due to collision. These are some of the common problem occur within the shop floor. So we have to prevent these hazards by following some standard safety regulations. And this is pertaining to the manual lifting. So when you are going for a manual lifting, there are some restrictions in terms of the physical weight of the raw material. So here it is given, if you are allowing a man or a woman to lift the material manually, this is the weight restriction, maximum the threshold point. So beyond which we should not take overload to lift the manual materials without the use of lifting mechanisms. And follow safety postures, body motion postures, when you are lifting the manual weight. And here, these are some of the unsafe act occur in a wrong operable of a forklift truck. Ensure when you are operating a forklift truck, your body is fully covered within the overhead protection system or not. Don't show your head or hand when the vehicle is on the move, moving on the path. And don't keep your arm as a support on the top of the overhead protection. And advisable to keep the leg on the brake foot pedal. Don't keep away the leg outside, away from the brake foot pedal. It may lead to some accidents at any course of time, knowingly or unknowingly. So these are considered to be unsafe act as per the safety hazards. And these are the standard regulations to be followed when you are operating the forklift truck. So don't keep any attachment on the fork lever without reading the necessary precautions, and check whether both the forklift are in stable manner, and there should be a clearance gap from the ground level. The fork must be kept at a height of 15-20 centimeter away from the ground level, and if there is any obstacle in front of the forklift, take a movement in the reverse direction by actuating the reverse gear, so that we can able to maintain the stability of the vehicle in the case of obstacle, and drive at a very safe speed. Avoid a sudden stop and stop when the people are crossing the pathway. Then avoid over driving on any object lying on the path. So finally, what I mean to say, the safe material handling is fully based on the efficient usage of ergonomic design for a human worker. And each and every human worker has to follow the safety rules and guidelines according to the workplace conditions. And that will lead to overall enhancement of the productivity of material handling system, depending on the aid of skilled professionals. I thank each and every one for attending the meeting on material handling system. Thank you one and all. We will see the next interesting meeting on industrial practices.